Hi guys, hope you've had a good week. I'm going to ask you to use your imaginations today. I want you to imagine that you're sitting all by yourself in your living room. You're the rest of your family somewhere else, and you're by yourself in the living room, and you hear a knock on the door. You run, answer the door, and you open it, and to your amazement, a really famous preacher is standing there. Maybe someone you've seen on TV, or maybe you've seen pictures of him or her, or maybe you've watched a service online with your mom and dad, and you've seen that preacher. He's standing at your door, and you're so surprised. I think maybe that's what it must have been like for Jesse the day Samuel came to visit. You see, Samuel was the most famous preacher in Israel. He was the prophet, priest, an important leader in Israel, and he was at Jesse's door. And if that surprised Jesse, what Samuel said surprised him even more. Samuel said, "Jesse, God has told me to come to your house and pick the next king of Israel because he's going to be one of your sons." Well, Jesse was stunned. Imagine him thinking, "But I'm just a poor herdsman, a rancher. I wouldn't have a son who was supposed to be the king." But there was Samuel saying, "God has sent me, and God has promised to tell me which of your sons it will be. So let me see your sons. Let's start with the first one." Well, quickly Jesse thought, "Who is my most impressive son? Who is the one most likely to be the king?" And he thought of Eliab. So he called Eliab in. He was his tallest son, and he was very good looking. And Samuel looked at this handsome, tall young man, and he thought to himself, "Surely I'm looking at the next king of Israel. Right, God?" And God said, "No, it was not Eliab." Well, Jesse was kind of surprised. He thought, "Who would be the next most impressive of my sons?" And he thought Abinadab would probably be the next most likely candidate. So he called in Abinadab. And Abinadab wasn't as tall as Eliab, but he was also very good looking. And Samuel looked at him, and he looked at those broad shoulders, and he could just imagine the royal robes resting on those broad shoulders. Yes, he looked like he could be a king. "He is the one, right, God?" And God said, "No." Well, Jesse was probably a little perplexed by this time, but he thought, who would be the next most likely candidate? And he decided it would be Shammah. So he called in Shammah, and in came another good-looking young man. And Samuel looked at that beautiful head of hair, and he could just imagine a crown sitting on that head. He thought, "Yes, he looks like he could be the king. He's the one, right, God?" And God said, "No, it was not Shammah." Well, Jesse brought in four more sons. The Bible doesn't tell us their names. But four more times, Samuel looked at handsome young men. Four more times he prayed, "Is this the one, God?" And God said every time, "No." When he got through with those seven young men, Samuel looked at Jesse and he said, "You must have another son somewhere, because none of these was the one God has picked for the king." And Jesse said, "Well, yes, I do. I have another son, but he's just a kid. I mean, he's just a teenage boy. I don't think he would be the king." "Well, bring him in," Samuel said. So in came David. We don't know what he was doing at the time. Maybe he was taking care of the sheep or practicing his music, but he was somewhere far away, and he was brought in. He came running in, and Samuel looked at him, and he was really a cute kid, but he was so young. He was just a teenage boy. "Surely not this kid," Samuel thought to himself. "God, is he the one? Do you want him to be the next king of Israel?" And God said, "Yes." And then God said something very important to Samuel. He said, you human beings, you look at the outward appearance. You look at the beautiful hair and the handsome faces and the strong muscles. You look at things on the outside. But you know, those things aren't really all that important to me. I look at the heart. And this kid has a heart for me. Anoint him the next king of Israel. Well, Samuel had picked the king. David became the king, as Samuel had said. And a few years later, when David was a grown-up man, he was writing songs that are included in our Bible, many of them. One of the songs said, "I have hidden your word in my heart so I won't sin against you." That shows the kind of heart this young man had. He had hidden God's words in his hearts to keep him from sinning. Another one of his songs said, "Create in me a clean heart, O God." David knew that only God could give us a clean heart. He had a heart for God. And you know, God hasn't changed since all those thousands of years ago when he picked David to be the king. God still isn't all that impressed by beautiful hair or muscles or handsome faces. He still wants people with hearts that want to follow him, hearts that want to obey him. Let's pray and ask God to help us have those kinds of hearts. Dear God, we thank you for this story and for these words from Samuel that remind us of what's important to you, the condition of our hearts. You want hearts like David had, hearts that want to follow you and will hide your word in them. We pray that you will help us be people with those kinds of hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.